So for this section, we want to talk with you a bit about how the goddess tradition of Mahakali differs from others. In the Hindu and Buddhist traditions, for example, they'll have malas that will have 108 beads. We use one that has 54. Their malas are usually, some sort of, stone bead or whatever and stuff, and occasionally rudrakshas. We use rudraksha seeds also, but we also use powdered turquoise that's been formed to look like skulls. And again, that goes back to the Kapala and dealing with things with overcoming the fear of death. But we also do some other things. For instance, we, like many other earth-based traditions in the world, like Wicca and the Celtic witchcraft and much of the ancient Druid practices and such things as in with the worship of Isis and stuff, in the ancient days was, everyone did their ritual work nude, and we do as well. In Gardnerian Wicca, which is actually a form of Wicca that was started in England by Gerald Gardner, and was brought predominantly from Egypt, talked about how, in their initiation, talks about how nudity, or being sky clad, as the Wiccans like to say it, nudity is the symbol of the freedom that the goddess has given us. People who fear clothes, fear people without clothes and stuff, everyone came into this world with nothing but their body. Nobody came out of the womb dressed. This is the most natural thing in the world. And it's also a way to garner the most energy in the process of your work. If you have clothes on, especially if it's synthetic fabrics and things, then it really messes with the energy. And the less you have on, the better your energy will be. If you have to do some work wearing clothes and stuff, then our recommendation is that you wear natural fiber clothing. That can be, like wool, linen, cotton, leather, anything natural that isn't man-made, and it may be sewn by men, woven by men or women and stuff, but it's not a synthetic fabric. Synthetic fabrics put out a massive amount of formaldehyde, and that really is toxic and poisons your body and hampers your ability to hear the spirits and to work with spiritual energy. Now, we did a class on Kundalini Reiki a while back, challenged some people to try it, and one of the people went home and tried doing some hands-on healing with someone, and then waited a while and tried doing it with them in another room, and it was a lot better being with the distance and stuff. And then she took her clothes off and sent the energy, and she said it was just as if the energy was coming into every pore and going out of every pore all at once. And as with many of the different traditions, one of the things that we do is we train sacred prostitutes. I was trained to do this when I was a child. And, started doing this type of healing when I was 14, almost 15 years old. And one of the things that we find from that is anytime you see something on our website, anytime you see some of this video, you're receiving energy. Healing energy, but the energy is really good when we don't have anything on. Now, I will be doing some ritual things, and they will be posted on YouTube, but they will be posted on a private channel, and the only people who will have access to it is going to be someone that I send their email address in for it. So, if you want to subscribe to this and you want to check it out sometime, the first one that I will be doing will be a fervor ritual. And with the fervor, we'll be doing it for anyone who sees it to remove anything that's holding them back in their life and to bless them with energy that will help them achieve their true purpose. And so if you want to be able to see that, then my suggestion is you go to www.nakedshaman.net and you fill out the contact form and say that you would like to receive that. And then when the time comes, I will put your email address into that space. And once that video is done, it'll be sent to you. But other than that, everything that we do here will be closed. So ritual work will be done that way. We'll be doing some mantra work, some pujas, things of this nature. And all of those things will be on that site. And one of the things that you will need to state is that you're at least 18 years old. Because if you don't, you will not be added to the list. So that's not because people who are younger than 18 don't know what the human body is, but there's some really archaic, stupid laws in the United States, and so therefore we have to do it that way. As we do this work, one of the things that we recognize is that things in the so-called, you know, a lot of things in goddess traditions are considered to be matriarchal. Well, that's not entirely accurate when it comes to Mahakali. The thing that's going on in the world right now, we have, you know, ISIS running around doing a bunch of stuff. We have the Muslim Hiraj, where the Quran says that they are to go in the world and they are to make everyone else become like them, whether they like it or not. Christianity had the same thing with the Great Commission and their manifest destiny process, and they're kind of falling back and stuff, and the Muslims are kind of trying to take over that. But patriarchy, as we know it, died in the spirit world on the 23rd of April in 2003. The reason it needed to die is because it was something that's out of balance and it's fear-based. And the reason it was fear-based is matriarchy before that had gotten out of balance, and the women had done the same thing to the men that men in these aberrant religions do to women now. And so Mahakali is all about balance, and the Yab-Yum, which is this symbol of the goddess and Mahakali having intercourse together, is about bringing balance, a balance between the masculine and the feminine. And so what we need in the world is not to go back to matriarchy. And we certainly don't need to stay in patriarchy. We need something new. We need to go back to the point where women and men are working in a balanced society, equal responsibility, equal rights, and everyone, you know, honors and respects everyone else. There are a lot of different religions that have different things like the golden rule. The Jewish version is don't do anything to anyone else that you don't want them to do unto you. The Christian version is do unto others as you would have them do unto you. We see this as a little bit of a problem in that, let's say I'm a sadomasochist, so I'm going to hurt you so you'll hurt me. You know, that fits that rule. You know, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. So, we like the Wiccan bit, where the Wiccans had the Wiccan read, and it harm none, do what you will, except in the case of self-defense. And it harm none by either your standard or theirs. That's pretty good. From the end of things with Mahakali and the Tibetan Kapali Kirigora path, our one rule when it comes to dealing with other people is don't do anything to anyone that you would ever have to apologize for later. You know, pretty simple, kind of like the witches stuff, you know. And so if we have a society that runs that way, then everyone pretty much gets along. If we have a situation where, you know, someone harms someone else, then yeah, you have to deal with it. And, you know, when you have a society where people respect each other and everyone is carrying their own weight and playing their part in society, whatever that part works out to be, then, you know, this is good. We don't need necessarily even to call it by another name. All we have to do is, you know, this is who we are, this is the way we live, and we go on. So a lot of what we do, in fact, just about everything that we do in Tibetan Kapalika Agora is about finding balance. There are people who say that you shouldn't do anything that's considered black magic. Well, black magic in a Western European understanding of things is not the same thing as black magic in an Asian understanding of things. There's black magic, red magic, yellow magic, blue magic, you know, white magic. We do them all as they're needed. Black magic is about liberation, and it's about liberation is about dealing with some spirit that's gotten out of control. And if it can't be stopped in some way, then you do a full liberation process where it ceases to exist and goes back to be a part of the void, which is the unmanifest energy of the universe. And so that's probably the most extreme thing we do. But people, anytime you do something to defend yourself or something like that, and someone else, even if they deserved it, gets hurt, they think it's black magic. You don't. You think it's pretty good. So black magic, white magic, all this sort of stuff is very subjective. So we do things as they're needed, but we don't do them in excess, and we try and do everything in balance. Now, as with everything else, with the Cherokee end of things, with the Tibetan end of things, whatever and stuff, we also never fight against what we hate. We only fight for what we love. And when we're not having to deal with something like that, then we're doing everything we can to heal ourselves and everything else in the world, because the more healing there is and the more empowerment there is, then the less of a problem there is. And so, just as I'm the dragon priest for the Tibetan Kapalika Agora path, we also have a dragon mother. And Raven Mahakali is fully my equal in every way. And she is the current carrier of the full energy of Mahakali in this world. And she is she does a lot to determine the path that we're on, and the things that that we're working on, and as we work to bring things back in balance. And so you won't see her on a lot of these videos, but there's a possibility that we'll be able to do something with her in the near future and have her on as well. So this is how we work. This is what we're after. Mahakali is all about balance. That's why she created Mahakali first. And we are all about balance. And so, again, if you want to be able to see the ritual work and stuff that we'll do in post, then you need to send us, fill out the contact form at www.nakedshaman.net. And we will put you on the list. But other than that, we'll try and have a video or two on here every week and share some of our teachings with you. We'll get into the Kali Naga shamanism as far as specific practices and stuff that you can do to better your life, starting with the next video. So that's it for now, and we'll see you soon.